Also, there are a number of ledgers for tracking cash and assets through the system, as well as journals that hold transactions that were received from other sources but are not yet recorded in the ledger. Then there is an audit trail used to document each step of each actor along the way. On top sits processing software that connects all those ledgers, master files and journals. Audit processes ensure a frictionless operation between them. Peters and Panayi, 2015. Banks also hold accounts that are recorded in a central body's ledger, for example, a central bank. Underpinning the entire transaction system is the SWIFT, or Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication Network, with its financial platform SWIFTNET, a private exchange network not built on P2P trust like the blockchain, but on a centralised model. All these processes and actors obviously come at a cost. The fee for remittances is 8-9% of the transaction value, whereas the transaction fee for Bitcoin is 0.01-0.05%, Peters and Panayi, 2015. At least, that was what the world's Bitcoin enthusiasts imagined. Within 3 years, as Bitcoin was pushed towards its scalability limits, fees soared to around $19 per transaction, Hertig 2018. Scalability, however, is only a showstopper for Bitcoin, not for the blockchain. The point is that the blockchain mechanism is slimmed down, and with the right technical setup, it can trim costs to the bone. The cost of transactions is not just monetary, however. Time is also a major factor. Every transaction comprises 3 steps. It starts with the authorization at the time of purchase or wire transfer. This can be the terminal at the grocery store verifying your chip card and its available amount, or a 4-digit code sent by text message to validate a bank wire.